Hello you gorgeous people, this is Chris from Rokombo and I'm here with a very intriguing new handset indeed, the IO Pro 3D from a company called Rokit. You might not have heard of Rokit before, smartphone manufacturer that's about to go global. They've just launched here in the UK and they've just released two new smartphones. This is the slightly more premium model, the IO Pro 3D, costs you 250 quid. You can pre-order now on Amazon and it will be sent out from the April the 4th apparently. You can also get a slightly more budget friendly version, just the IO 3D, which will cost you 140 quid. So we're going to give it a full unboxing now and run through some of the reasons why this is one of the more intriguing new handsets that we've come across. So as you can see, first of all, even the box is quite unusual and that it's an actual carry case type affair instead of your standard just boring white box. Bit of the Rokit logo on there and it says IO Pro 3D down there too. Let's just get it unboxed. It's a very solid feeling case. It's got a sort of a plasticky finish to it, but it feels pretty rugged, like that would take a good old thumping. So at least if you are getting this delivered by Amazon, it should survive the journey. And there is the phone. Oh no, I tell a lie, that is not the phone itself, that is a plastic cover for the phone. Always good to see that bundle. I believe you only get that with the Pro 3D rather than just the standard IO 3D. Oh, what else? I'm guessing this is the USB charging cable. Yep, there you have it, and it is unfortunately micro USB, it is not type C, boo, but never mind, can't have everything. And you get a little bit of pamphlet action as well, a little quick startup guide, all that kind of shenanigans, and oh yes, a bit of pokey pin action as well, lovely stuff. And then for the phone itself, that must be hidden away. Here we go. How the flip do you get this thing out? Prize that bit out, and there we go, there is the Rokit IO Pro 3D. So we'll get that all set up now. So you can of course use this to carry around the phone for some reason, although it's a bit of a big one for the phone. You can stick in basically whatever you like, I guess. It's a handy little bonus accessory. There we go, as you can see, designed by Rokit in California. So Rokit is actually an American company. Will it be challenging Apple anytime soon? Well, with these kind of prices, it's definitely imminent, a very different kind of market. Let's just get the sticker off. Oh no, it balls that one up. Yeah, peel off that screen protector type jobby. There we have it. So there is the Rokit IO Pro 3D. As you can see there, it's got a glossy finish on the back. I believe it's just a polycarbonate finish rather than actual glass. Seems to be fairly resistant to smudges and the rest, though, helped along obviously by the dark coloration. As you can see there, a bit of the Rokit logo, and you do get the branding down below as well, but that's pretty much it. Rear-mounted fingerprint sensor, slightly indented into the surface there, so that's nice and easy to find with your finger, hopefully. Dual lens rear camera, we'll get to the camera chops in a bit. Let's just see if we've got any juice in the tank. We do, hooray, you get one life, Rokit, yeah. That's right, kiddies, YOLO, etc. As you can see there, no notch action or anything like that. This is very much a traditional smartphone. And as you can see there as well, of course, as you've probably gathered by the fact that it's called the 3D, it does actually have a 3D display in it. Something that we haven't seen on a smartphone since 2011, I believe, was the last time, with the likes of the LG Optimus 3D. So let's just dial down that brightness a bit because that's very bright. Before I forget, I'll just slap on the old cover that gets bundled in the box as well to show that off. So there you go. As you can see, it doesn't add much in the way of girth or anything like that, just wrap around all of the edges and we'll just add a little bit of extra protection. It doesn't seem to go all the way actually up to the very top surface, so if you do drop the phone face down you may still damage the screen, but yeah, you can still, as you can see there, it's nice and transparent, you can still see the funky Rokit brand and if that's a deal breaker or not. So the screen itself is a 6-inch, or it's a 5.99-inch if you want to be pedantic about it, IPS display, full HD plus resolution. As you can see there, immediately your desktops, you've got this funky planetary 3D effect. It does actually work really nicely. You do get sort of a proper sense of depth with it. Of course, the eye tracking is just done with the front-facing camera and everything as well. It seems to do the job nicely. As you can see there, nice and crisp as well. It's a shame that all the menus haven't been tweaked as well to give them a sort of a funky 3D effect, but that's still quite impressive stuff. It looks like you can actually change up the animation and everything as well, if you like. But of course, what is the point of a 3D screen if you haven't got anything to support it beyond a funky desktop or two? Well, thankfully, Rokit has not simply slapped a 3D screen on it and then left it at that. It does actually have its own Netflix-style service for 3D content called, as you can see there, RokFlix 3D, highly imaginative. So at the moment, RokFlix 3D is just a bunch of custom-made content, but apparently, according to Rokit, we will be getting some proper Hollywood-level 3D movies and TV content and stuff like that in the future, in the coming months. And there will be new stuff added on a weekly or monthly basis. So at least if you are invested in the 3D technology, if that's what you're buying the smartphone for, then it will be covered off with all that. Well, about the rest of the smartphone, you get a Mediatek MT6763 chipset on board. Of course, Mediatek, they can be a bit hit and miss. So far, obviously, it's got this 3D animated background and it seems to be enjoying life absolutely fine. You need to pull up your apps, dive on into the recent apps, yada, yada, yada. Seems to be enjoying life all right, but of course I'll be giving it a full testing out ahead of an in-depth review, so stay tuned for that. You've got 4 gigs of memory anyway on board as well, so hopefully should be absolutely fine for all of your various games, apps, whatever you want to do with it. I'm liking the dark mode finish as well on the menus and everything as well, something that you don't get with stock Android just yet, so that's always nice to see. It should hopefully help with the battery life as well, speaking of which, it's a 3850 milliamp cell stuck away on the Rokit IO Pro 3D, so hopefully that should keep you going easily over a day. We would hope for hopefully a sort of a day and a half to 2 days, depending on how much you're using it, but of course the likes of the 3D background may suck up the juice a bit faster, so again, stay tuned for my in-depth review. And as for the storage, you get 64 gigs on board. A large chunk of that is available to use as well, which is always good to see. And you do have microSD memory card support as well of up to 256 gigs. So you're basically set. Apparently with the RokFlix service, you can download movies and shows and stuff to enjoy offline as well. So plenty of space for all of that. And what about the camera tech? Well, if we dive on into the camera, which I'm assuming is done via this, so there you go, as you can see, it looks like a fairly sort of stock Android camera experience. Of course, you've got your shutter button and everything. Bit of flash action. So it's a dual lens snapper. You get a 13 megapixel primary lens backed by a basic 2 megapixel depth sensor for the likes of your portrait shots. Of course, you've got usual beauty mode and everything as well. How do you actually get to the various other modes? Are there various other modes? Yes, there we go. Quick swipe that way. So kind of similar to the old style Huawei effort. Swipe that way, brings up all the various modes. As you see there, you've got super night mode. Let's check that out. Is that a long exposure mode? It looks like it might be. So that'll be interesting to check out. You've got a separate HDR mode, so again, very similar to Huawei smartphones. An SLR mode, which I'm assuming is like a pro mode. Oh, bit of a stutter there. That just basically allows you to play around with the aperture setting by looks, but I'm assuming it doesn't go all the way to f1.0, the actual hardware though, so that'll be interesting to test out. And that appears to be the only option there. We've also got a child mode, which presumably, I don't know, even know what that does. I know whenever I try something with my child, it generally ends up a blurry mess. So it'll be interesting if that could sort that out. I'm guessing it might struggle a bit. So lots of different modes to play around with. As you can see there, you can choose the resolution that you shoot at. Got a bit of facial recognition and lots of other options as well. And then if you swap it around to the front, it's an 8 megapixel front facing camera. Once again, you've got your beauty mode and everything. It seems to be detecting my face quite nicely. A little snappy snap snaps. And you've got very basic mode on this one. If your child has nicked the phone, it can turn on its own child mode. So yeah, beautiful. I will, of course, again, be testing out the camera in full for that in-depth review, so stay tuned for all of that. Now, another interesting thing definitely worth pointing out with the IO Pro 3D is for every smartphone purchase, Rokit will actually give you a comprehensive insurance package and unlimited Wi-Fi calling to the UK and abroad. Not all countries, but a lot of countries included in that. The insurance package includes all kinds of stuff, national vehicle breakdown, you get personal accident coverage, even funeral care coverage up to, I think it was like 5 grand or something like that. So if you drop dead while you're rocking the Rokit IO Pro or 3D, hopefully not because of the smartphone, your loved ones can bung you in the ground for $5,000 less than it would have cost them. And this all stems from the US, where Rokit decided to add extra value for money by giving comprehensive over-the-phone healthcare to every Rokit smartphone user. Obviously, the situation's quite different over there in terms of the healthcare and everything, so they decided to do something similar over here in the UK. Obviously, we've already got the free healthcare via the telephone and everything, so in that case, we've got a very different kind of package. So here in the UK, if you do buy a Rokit smartphone, you'll get the ultimate package, which normally costs £12 a month. You'll get that free for 3 months, and then you can opt in after that 3 months if you decide to keep it up. Otherwise, you can just ditch it. And you can start it again at any point as well. It's on a monthly subscription basis, a rolling subscription, and you can cancel it, start it up again as much as you like. Full details are on Rokit's website anyway. I won't bang on about it too much here. So all right, there is the Rokit IO Pro 3D, as I say, £250 from amazon.co.uk. Definitely a very intriguing smartphone. It's obviously going up against some strong competition from the likes of the Moto G7, G7 Plus, things like that. The Honor 8X, of course, and the Honor Play. But definitely, if you're intrigued by the 3D, some may say it is a gimmick, but it definitely seems to work absolutely fine in our hands-on time, that's for sure. Maybe a gimmick, but at least it works. And of course, if you're going to get some genuine value out of the insurance stuff, the free Wi-Fi call and everything as well, then it's probably worth considering. But as I say, stay tuned for my in-depth review to tell you everything you need to know about the actual smartphone itself and whether it is worth picking up. So cheers everyone, let us know your own personal thoughts down below, and don't forget to subscribe and ding that notifications bell for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech. Ta!